various groups troop to the Philippine Senate to call for a higher budget for the benefits of healthcare workers. ABS-CBN's Mike Navallo now on the line to tell us more about this. Mike, go ahead.
Hi, Carmina. More than 300 healthcare workers and members of various progressive groups took to the Senate Thursday to call on senators to review the budget allocated to healthcare workers under the Bayanihan laws. They also called on the Senate to assure continued provision of funds for special risk allowance, meals, accommodation, transportation allowance, and compensation for healthcare workers stricken with COVID-19. Donel Ciazon, USC Hospital Employees Union President and PHWAT member, said only 80% of healthcare workers have so far received their special risk allowance, while 70-80% have not yet received their meal, accommodation, transportation allowance. No healthcare worker who contracted COVID, he said, has received compensation. Ciazon is calling on senators to review where the funds for these benefits went as the Senate goes over the proposed 2022 budget. At the very least, he said, all they're asking is for the government to continue providing healthcare workers with benefits next year. The House of Representatives transmitted to the Senate on October 25 House Bill number 1153, or the 2022 General Appropriations Bill, with a $5.024 trillion proposed budget for 2022. An additional 20 billion pesos under the Department of Health was allocated for the procurement of vaccines and booster shots, and a 4.5 billion budget for the special risk allowance of qualified public and private health workers. Meanwhile, presidential aspirant at Bukluran ng mga manggagawang Filipino chair, Caliodi D. Guzman, is calling for a 5-year debt moratorium and the scrapping of the Marcos-era automatic appropriations law. RA-1177, or the automatic appropriations law, automatically appropriates a portion of the budget for debt servicing, more than 540 billion pesos, or 10% of the proposed 2022 budget, will go to debt servicing. D. Guzman said this amount could go to meals, accommodation, transportation allowance of healthcare workers. He hit the government for prioritizing payment of debt and businesses of billionaires in the midst of a pandemic. The program was very brief, Carmina. It lasted for about just a little over an hour, and by now, the front gate of the Senate, where the protest action was held, is now cleared of any protesters. Carmina?
Thanks a lot. Mike Navallo there joining us on the line. Keep safe, Mike. Take care.